Friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. Today in this video, we are going to see the top trending technologies and highly paid and demanded technologies for 2019. Let's begin our video. First trending technology is mobile application. Mobile application, it is used to run the mobile devices, and we can design the mobile devices and tablets, watches, etc. using mobile application. It is having high demand, and it is also used to produce the assistants for email, and we can also use it for calendar app and few databases and others. And next, coming to the second technology, it is about data security. Data security is nothing but providing the security to the data and protecting our data from unauthorized users. Unauthorized users means the users who do not have any right to access our data are known as unauthorized users. Okay, so nowadays unauthorized users and other users who should not see our data, we need to protect our data from them. So we are using data security, and data security also helps us to protect our data from cyber attack. Okay, and next is Java. Coming to Java, it is a general purpose programming language, and it has a concept of OOPS. And the Java is very popular because it has the tendency to write once and run anywhere, run any number of times. Okay, once we write the code, we can run it anywhere, any number of times, and it supports all the platforms. That's why it is very popular. And next technology is Agile. Agile is nothing but it is one of the approach which is used for software development, and it advocates adaptive planning. Okay, it also helps us in adaptive planning so that we can make the early delivery and continuous improvements, okay, for the product or the software. And next is SQL, which stands for Structured Query Language. Structured Query Language is designed for managing data in relational database management system, and it is used in different databases to write a queries and to manage a queries. If you want to create a table, you have to write a query. If you want to alter your table or alter the contents in the table, you have to write a query. So that's why it is known as queried language. The query, when you write in it in a particular structure, it is called as structured query language. Okay, and next is IPaaS. IPaaS is nothing but it is used for toll collection at highways. Okay, IPaaS is an electronic toll collection system which is used by ISTHA. ISTHA means it is a state toll highway authority. Okay, and it is also one of the most trending technology in 2019. And next is XML, which stands for Extensible Markup Language. Okay, using Extensible Markup Language, we can define the set of rules for encoding documents. Okay, and XML is used for creating the documents in the format which is both human readable and machine readable. Okay, the documents which we can read. Human readable means which we can read. Machine readable means which machine can read. Okay, and there are many specifications, and XML mainly focuses on documents, language, and representation of web services. Okay, next technology is SAP Cloud. Okay, SAP Cloud is nothing but it is an open platform as a service. Okay, SAP Cloud platform is nothing but it provides a platform as a service. Okay, whenever we require platform, it provides it as a service. Platform is nothing but it is an environment where we where we do things, okay, where we develop a software and like that, okay, whenever we require platform, SAP Cloud provides that platform, and it is very popular because it is a third party. The cloud is a third party, but it provides high security to our data. It also provides software as a service, platform as a service, and also security to our data. So it is highly preferred technology nowadays, okay? And next is Unix, okay? Coming to Unix, Unix is nothing but Unix systems are characterized by modular design that is sometimes called Unix philosophy. And coming to Unix, this concept it is related to the operating system, and it provides some easy tools which are easy to understand and handle, and it also involves shell scripting and other commanding languages. And next is cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is nothing but protecting our data and providing security to our data, software, hardware, so that the data and the systems will not be theft or damaged from others. Okay, so that there is no like misdirection or misconception happening to our data as well as resources. Okay, and this field is having a very importance because it can be used for many networks which are wireless. That's why it is having high importance nowadays. And next is artificial intelligence. Artificial is intelligence is nothing but we are giving intelligence to the machines, okay? So that the machines will themselves perform an activity upon our guidance or upon our instructions, okay? That is called artificial intelligence. And the term artificial intelligence, it itself saying the intelligence which is happening artificially, like the intelligence which humans have is natural intelligence. But whenever we give that intelligence, like whenever we transfer that intelligence to the machines or non-living beings, that is called artificial intelligence. First, what they do is we train the machines and we test the machines. Like after training, we have to test them whether they are performing correctly or not. And then we have to assign a task to the machines, okay? So that it can itself do an activity which is given by the human, okay? Next is data science. Data science is nothing but it is a field where it consists of the structured and unstructured data. When the data is in a particular structure or format, it is called structured data. When the data does not have any kind of structure, it is called the unstructured data. And the data science is used for the programming systems, and it has the efficient algorithms to solve many problems. Okay, next important trending technology is Internet of Things. Internet of Things is very, very important. It is nothing but we are connecting the non-living things in the home and making them smart. Okay, I'll give you an example. Using Internet of Things, we can connect all the things in our home. For example, when I enter into my room, the light should be automatically switch on. When I exit the room without permission, it should automatically off the light, okay? And for example, another example is whenever the water level is beyond a particular mark, then the motor switch should automatically off, okay? Like without the human interaction, the thing should happen, okay? So this is called internet of things. Like we are giving the smartness to the things, so it is called the internet of things. Okay, it is just like sensors. Okay, and you can read the content here. We can using internet of things technology, we can give intelligence to our products, home products, and make our home as smart home. Next is big data. Big data, the name itself is saying big data. Nowadays, day by day, the data is increasing, and the data is not like the data is not possible to stop. It is continuous flow. Okay, so what we need to do is we have to take a particular method which helps us to handle that huge data. Okay, so what we do is we follow the concept of big data. Okay, what big data does is it helps us to manipulate the data and control the data, and easily we can handle the data using big data. Okay, and using the big data, what we can do is we can easily handle huge data easily, like without any complexity. Okay, and big data challenges include capturing of the data, storing the data, analyzing the data, searching the data, transferring the data, and sharing the data, visualizing the data, querying the data, updating the data, and maintaining the privacy to the data, and sourcing the data. Okay, the source, the sources from which we get the data is called data source. Okay, and three main concepts of big data is volume, variety, velocity. Volume is nothing but how large is the data. Variety means from how many different sources we are getting the data. Velocity means how fast the data is increasing. Okay, next, API. API is nothing but, it stands for application programming interface. It is nothing but, it is a protocol, it is a communication protocol, and it consists of the different tools for building the software. Okay, and it is clearly a method of communication. Okay, so it means that what we do is we use API in order to develop the computer program by providing all the building blocks. Okay, so what we do is we will collect all the building blocks and provide those building blocks to the programmer so that he can put all the building blocks together. Building blocks are nothing but, it is just the criteria or the specifications of how to develop the software. Okay, and yes, next technology is SaaS, which stands for software as a service. Okay, so new business or new companies cannot afford for softwares because few softwares are economical, like we can easily buy them, but few softwares are really very costly. Okay, the small scale companies or the small businesses cannot afford for such a software which is of high cost. Then what we do is we will get the software for service, okay, by paying the minimum cost of rent or something like that. We will just rent a software which is called software as a service. Okay, the like some of the people who provides the software as a service, they will make sure that the software is up to the mark and does not have any limitations, because they are renting their software, and the software will also have the license, okay? And there are many softwares which will be under SaaS, that is we can take office software as a service and messaging software as a service and DBMS software as a service and processing software as a payroll processing software also we can take it as a service, okay? And next technology is DevOps. DevOps is nothing but software, DEV, okay? The DevOps, the three first letters DEV is taken from software development, okay? And OPS is taken from information technology operations, okay? Hence the name has come DevOps, okay? So what DevOps is does is it updates the software frequently and it makes sure it will fix all the limitations which the software possesses, okay? And cloud security, okay? We already saw this concept. The cloud will provide the software as a service and platform as a service. So when we take the software or platform on rent from the cloud, our data should be having high security. So here comes the concept of cloud security, like how the cloud provides the security to its users, clients, comes under the cloud security. And next is cloud infrastructure. The infrastructure which cloud possesses comes under cloud infrastructure. And the cloud infrastructure is of different types. There will be direct management by the user, by the computer system resources. Like whenever we need few resources, we can rent it from the cloud. So it is known as computer system resources, and there we can store our data. And if we want the third party, which is our client, like I'll give you an example. ABC, C is the cloud providers, okay, the cloud security people. A is me and B is my client. What I does is I want like I am not available in the location, so my client wants to see the data from the cloud providers. What he does is he first needs to ask my permission, because it is my data. So once I grant permission, he will have all the rights to see the data, okay? Such that the unauthorized access will also not be there. Like once I gave permission only, then my client can access or view the data. So that is the concept of cloud security also here. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. If you want to purchase any IEEE projects, major projects, mini projects, Java projects or any other projects, you can mail to bestwaytostudy7@gmail.com. Please don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends, and thanks for watching.